Look guys, we were able to get Old Master in 2.5 weeks, so I really don't think that unlocking Farmboy Luke or Princess Leia is going to be any worse than that. I mean, how much more difficult could it possibly be?
I'm not afraid.
You will be. You will be.
Always good to have you here, my friend. Whoa! Yo, I killed 7 with that grenade.
You've obviously never fought a Jedi, have you?
Huh? Whoa. Whoa! You good, bro? Hello? I wish my head could do that. Yeah. Oh, damn. Yo, appreciate that sub. Means a lot. What? 4 away? Oh my god. Oh my god. We did it! We got Farmboy. Let's go, baby. Let's go. You know what that means. Oh. 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 Shit. 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 Oh my god. What am I doing? Alright, let's try this. Wait. Wait, what? How did I get the kill? I didn't do anything. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all having a fantastic week. Before we get into the video, I want to remind you that I stream Star Wars Battlefront 2 every day over on Twitch. Just go there and look up Original Bon Jovi or click the link in the description. I really appreciate all the support you've shown to me lately, both on Twitch and here on YouTube. Now, in my last video, I gave my top 5 tips for how to unlock Old Master skin for Darth Maul. As I'm going to talk about here today, a lot of what I said before applies to these skins as well. I want to warn you, getting them is no easy task. I thought Old Master was a pretty tough grind, but I really had no idea what a tough grind was until I went for Farmboy and Princess. It almost goes without saying, but these are probably the most iconic skins in the game. The Farmboy appearance is how we're introduced to Luke Skywalker, a moisture farmer, in Episode 4 A New Hope, while the Princess skin for Leia Organa is taken from her capture by Darth Vader in the same movie. Even though I hardly ever play as Luke or Leia if I can help it, I have to say that they both look pretty good. Could DICE have added something better? Yeah, I think so. I would have liked to have Jedi Master Luke from Episode 8 The Last Jedi and General Leia from the sequel trilogy, but they didn't ask my opinion, and this is what we have. I really do think that Farmboy and Princess are the most difficult skins to unlock. Both of them require 5,000 kills using a light side hero. For some reason, my game was a bit buggy, which is why I needed 5 more for Princess than for Farmboy, but that's not surprising given how weird things are in Battlefront 2. The villain lineup is pretty overpowered at the moment, even though Darth Vader and Kylo Ren were recently nerfed and Darth Maul's abilities work about half the time. You can easily drop 100 or more kills with Bossk, Iden Versio, or Captain Phasma. In terms of abilities, I don't think the heroes come close to that. With that being said, my awesome viewers, who actually main heroes, helped me come up with some really good classes to speed up the process of getting these 2 rare skins. So rather than giving a list of tips, I just want to share the hero class setups that helped me unlock Farmboy and Princess in only 1 week's time. Although a number of people have done the whole grind on Supremacy, I stand by what I said in my Old Master video. The co-op game mode is the way to go, end of story. It's far easier to get the hero you want when you aren't competing with 19 other people. I frequently have people come into my stream and mock me for, quote, playing against bots, end quote. Obviously, I'm only doing co-op to complete the milestones, but if I'm being real with you, the bots are usually better than actual players in my experience. Han Solo is hands down the best hero to use. I never played as him before getting involved with this Farmboy and Princess stuff, and it took some real getting used to, but this guy is absolutely insane with the right cards. I like to run Smuggler's Wits at the max level, which adds a 2-second cooldown to all abilities, but gives an extra dodge. Comes in handy when you're dodging enemy fire or need a quick escape. Heavily modified blaster reduces the amount of heat that Han's gun builds up. Again, you gotta have the max level. 25% decrease in heat buildup is huge. Lastly, I use Sharpshooting Frenzy. Each kill that you get in Han's sharpshooter mode will make the ability last a little longer, and that'll give you an extra edge when grinding for these skins. This is definitely my favorite hero class setup in Battlefront 2 by far, and just the other day, I actually dropped back-to-back 100 plus kill games while playing co-op on Endor. Early on, a bunch of people in my stream suggested that I use the Broadshoulders card. This helps them to take less damage while charging at enemies. Personally though, I only use Shoulder Charge as a last resort. If you're playing it smart, you won't even be close enough to anyone to need it. Speaking for myself, I hate playing the sequel trilogy playlist. Maybe my luck is just horrible, but I tend to get put on the capital ships way more frequently than actual planetary maps. There are definitely spawn traps on the ships, lots of narrow hallways and stuff like that, but it's also far easier to be overwhelmed and a lot more difficult to escape in a pinch. However, Finn is an absolute beast. He's another one of those heroes that I rarely ever played as, so determining how to use his abilities and which cards are the best took some time. For anyone not familiar with his abilities, Deadeye is pretty much an aimbot. When you activate it, Finn will lock onto whatever target is closest to him in your field of vision and rapid fire. All three of these cards enhances Deadeye ability, which will be your best friend, as I said. No More Running increases damage after your first three Deadeye kills. Kind of like Han's Sharpshooting Frenzy card, Stay Calm extends the ability's duration with every additional kill. Finally, Raised to do one thing. This will allow you to lock onto enemies that are further away. He is honestly a great support class, so just hang back and let the lightsaber heroes do their thing while you pick people off from safety. I'm more aggressive, which is why I really prefer Han, but you can't go wrong with Finn either. I've heard from many people that Leia is actually super OP and one of the best heroes right now. If you guys have a good card setup for her, I'd love for you to let me know in the comments section, because I tried and tried and I've never been able to figure it out. Now that I've got the princess skin, I can flex that while trying out your setups. I also want to be clear that I'm open to other ideas. Han Solo and Finn work best for me, but I'm sure you guys have found other great ways to grind out these skins. Please remember to drop a like and sub if you enjoyed this video. Until next time guys, I'm Original Bon Jovi. Peace. Can I like... what can I do to this? Oh! Alright, well... the more you know... the less you care.